Leaders' questions, and the first question is from Deputy Dara Colliery. Has 3 minutes.
Before I begin, I just want to mention the appalling atrocity where 17 young people were shot dead, 50 more injured, in the Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Maryland in Florida. I think it's critical as a global community that we don't become complacent to such heedless, needless and gun-fueled violence. Our thoughts and our prayers are with those families. Your very basic right is that your children should go to school and come home safely, to those that are injured. And we send our solidarity to the people of the area and people of the USA as they grapple with yet another major school tragedy. I concur this morning, thousands of homeowners across the country are reading in the Irish Independent that their home loan is being put up for sale without their agreement. Permanent TSB are beginning to market a portfolio of home loans worth nearly €3 billion to a range of international investors, including those we know as vulture funds. It is estimated, Tánaiste, that this could represent up to 20,000 loans. That's 20,000 families who are facing a very uncertain future this morning. And I want to put that 20,000 figure into context. In quarter three in 2017, there was just over 11,000 family home loans held by unregulated vulture funds. This one sale could nearly triple that figure in one go. The loans would be sold at less than their actual value to these vultures, but the borrowers, these families, will still have to pay every cent of the loan plus interest. Many of the potential bidders for this portfolio are already here in Ireland, already in business in Ireland. And it hasn't been a good story. They are impossible to engage with. They don't have branches, they have call centres. They rely on anonymous call centres that may not even be based in the state to deal with customers. They are aggressive in dealing with borrowers and their families. They are aggressive to the point of causing considerable mental and physical stress to the people involved. And they get away with it, Tánaiste. They get away with that aggression because there is no regulation. They are accountable to nobody. And the Finance Committee has sought in recent weeks to try and get these people into the committee to engage with the committee. And virtually all of them have turned down the request of a committee of Oireachtas Éireann to go and account for their actions. But yet, we propose to hand another 20,000 families into the clutches. The PTSB is only the first. Other banks will follow suit. Loans involving more family homes, family farms, family businesses will be sold to the highest bidder with no regard for the families involved, for the borrowers involved. Tánaiste, I have a couple of questions. You own 75% of Permanent TSB. You are the main shareholder. You pay the piper. When was the government made aware by Permanent TSB of their decision to put this loan portfolio up for sale in this specific manner? Did the government at any time signal any concerns to Permanent TSB about family homes and about the treatment of families in this process? What protections are you seeking for those families? And finally, Tánaiste, Minister Dunne's spokesperson said this morning, quote, some banks, including PTSB, end of quote, were considering the sale of portfolios. What other banks, in addition to Permanent TSB, was she and therefore the Minister referring to?
Thank you, Deputy, for raising this issue. And I think it's important to say to the House that we want to complete the repair of the banking system and ensure that banks are there to support the wider public interest, which is the whole purpose of a functioning banking system within an economy, as set out in the programme for government. Dealing with high non-performing loans is one of the key priorities of the European regulator, the single supervisory mechanism. While great progress has been made in the Irish banks, the SSM has made it clear that further reductions need to be made. At 28% as of last June, PTSB's non-performing loan ratio was one of the highest in the Eurozone. Given the volume of borrowers who have not engaged with the bank in recent years and the number of cases where treatments were not possible or have failed, the bank has said that achieving an acceptable non-performing loan ratio won't be possible without some form of loan sales. Under the terms of the relationship framework with the bank, loan sales do not require the Minister for Finance's consent. However, the bank will be required to consult with the Minister and will do so in due course. In any loan sale, it is important to highlight that the contractual terms of borrowers or indeed tenants remain in place post the loan sale, while the Central Code of Conduct for mortgage arrears still applies. In other words, mortgage holders have the same rights regardless of who owns the loan book. While loan sales are regrettable, the Minister for Finance is conscious of the need for the bank to continue on a path of recovery. The Government, to answer your questions, Deputy, the Government was briefed on this by the Minister for Finance on Tuesday at the last Government meeting. As regards your question on other banks, I know that Ulster Bank had a loan sale, I think it was last year or 18 months ago. Of course people are concerned as to who are going to be managing their loans and who they will be talking to or negotiating with in terms of debt. We're very conscious of that, but we're also conscious of the rules that apply. And there is a significant onus on the central bank to make sure that when loans are sold, the contractual rights of those who are linked to those loans continue to apply, and we'll do that.
Deputy Dara Cleary.
The Ulster funds are not regulated by the Central Bank. They're untouchable
by the Central Bank. And you know it, every deputy here knows it. We've been dealing with these, and they have no regard for the Central Bank, they have no regard for the Oireachtas, they have no regard for the law. They are pursuing borrowers with no intent, and we deal with them all here. And the notion that, you know, in due course the government will engage with permanent TSB, they have said this morning, it's out there, 20,000 families, their loans are up for grabs. Now is the time to engage with them, not in due course. Now is the time to actually say to permanent TSB, look, you've got to protect these families. These aren't non-entities. These aren't systems. There are people living in family homes the length and breadth of this island this morning. And yes, some of them may have had difficulties with their loans, but they have tried to engage, and that engagement will now count for nothing when it goes on to one of these funds. That has been our experience as deputies in dealing with these funds. So, Minister, I acknowledge the apologies. Try and put the interests of families at the front of this. You're obsessed about fixing the system. Think about families who today face such an uncertain future, and stand up for the rights of those people whose family homes are under threat as we speak.
Tanis Jett, 1 minute.
And I have to say it is difficult to take this lecture from Fianna Fáil in terms of thinking about families and loan books, given what your party was responsible for in terms of the banking sector. Our job as a government is to try to fix. Our job as a government is to try to fix what you broke.
Deputies, please. Let's have some order.
And the tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands, of families that have suffered as a result of that banking collapse, which was directly linked to poor banking, regulatory and government policy, is what we have spent the last 6.5 years fixing. And we will continue to try and fix that in a way that does prioritise families, that does try to protect people in their homes, and does try to give them state-funded supports in terms of the advice that they need to get through a difficult debt and finance management journey, which is what many families continue to be on. We also need to ensure that the central bank has the powers it needs to ensure that, regardless of who owns loan books, the way in which they are managed in terms of keeping people in their homes and protecting the public interest is to the forefront of what we're doing.